In this segment, we'll look at some examples of inconsistent and consistent system equations. So we know that, hey, a particular system of equations can still be consistent if it has a solution, and that solution can be either unique or infinite, and we're considering a system of equations to be inconsistent if it has no solution at all. So let's look at this example right here. Someone says 2, 4, 1, 3, xy is equal to 6 and 4. This set of equations is considered to be, it has a unique solution. How do I know that it's a unique solution? That's something we will talk about in the future segments. So this one has a unique solution, and if you are going to solve these equations, two unknowns and two unknowns, by any method, you're going to get 1, 1 as a solution. You can also look at that, hey, if I substitute 1 and 1 here, I'll get 6 and 4. So that is one of the solutions, but it's a unique solution. So we consider this system of equations to be consistent because it has a solution, and that solution we are telling you at this time is unique. Now, if I would look at this particular system of equations, like 2, 4, 1, 2, x, y is equal to 6 and 3. This one has infinite solutions. This one has infinite solutions. So, like, for example, I can have 1, 1. 1, 1 is a solution. Another solution for this set of equations is 0, 1.5, and so on and so forth. In fact, you can put 1 and 1, you get 6 and 3. If you put 0 and 1.5, you're going to get 6 and 3. But the number of solutions which you can find, which look like this, is infinite. So both of these, this system of equations and this system of equations, they are consistent because they have a solution. And why does this have infinite solutions? You can, if you write these as equations, you get 2x plus 4y is equal to 6, and you get x plus 2y is equal to 3. You can very well see that this equation is simply a multiple of this equation. That if I take this second equation and I multiply it by 2, I get the first equation. So if you were going to draw it on a piece of graph paper, you'll find out that this line is on top of this line. They're not parallel lines, but they are on top of each other. Hence, you have infinite solutions. So that's just a way of looking at when you have two equations, two unknowns. Once you start getting into three equations, three unknowns, or four equations, four unknowns, it'll be harder to visualize that. Let's look at another set of equations. Let's suppose I have the same thing, 2, 4, 1, 2, x, y is equal to 6 and 2. And in this case, I will have no solution. There is no solution which exists for this set of equations right here. And people might say that, hey, what is different about this set of equations and this set of equations is that if I would expand this, I'll get 2x plus 4y equal to 6, x plus 2y equal to 2. If you are going to draw this on a piece of graph paper, you'll find two parallel lines which will never intersect with each other. Hence, there is no solution for this set of equations. As opposed to this one, you have two parallel lines, but they're on top of each other. So that's why you have infinite solutions. So these two right here, these are consistent system of equations. And right here, you get inconsistent system of equations. And one of the things which you're finding out here is that for the same coefficient matrix here and here, that you can possibly get inconsistent or no solution, which is inconsistent, or you can get infinite solutions, which is also part of the consistent solution. So one of the things which I'm trying to say here is just be aware of the fact that here we got two sets of equations with the same coefficient matrix. In one case we're getting infinite solutions, in another case we're getting no solution. But if I was going to, I will not be able to develop a set of equations with this as the coefficient matrix where I'll get a unique solution. So think about it for a little bit about why I'm saying those things, but that'll be much clearer when we talk about, hey, how do we figure out If somebody gives a set of equations, not two questions, two unknowns, but 1,000 equations, 1,000 unknowns, let's suppose, how do I make the distinction between it being consistent or inconsistent? And if I once made the determination that it's consistent, how do I know whether it has infinite solutions or a unique solution? And that's the end of this segment.